is on the way. It's time for the Rhema word. It's time for the word of the Lord for tonight. The young man that is coming to us tonight is coming to us from Rockingham, North Carolina. Pastor Timothy Newton, my son and brother. God bless you tonight. In Jesus' name, preach the word.
Come on, clap your hands and clap praise over there. To the Spirit of Christ that is certainly in this place, to Bishop Bloomer, thanks for this wonderful opportunity, to all these great men of God, to the great singer we've heard thus far, to this wonderful network. I believe God has predestined us for a great time of praise on tonight. I want to turn your attention to 2 Chronicles 20, verse number 17. Ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. The topic that I want to present to the jury and let them deliberate and bring back the victory report is victory has been arranged. Victory has been arranged. As I commence, I want to make you aware of the fact that according to 2 Chronicles 18, Jehoshaphat had just exited a battle in which he told Ahab that he would accompany him in war. First, let me suggest, be careful who you connect with in your season of victory. Verse 31 in chapter 18 reveals to the reader that as the enemy surrounded him, Jehoshaphat cried out and the Lord helped him. The Lord told me to tell somebody tonight, you've got help. Hallelujah. In verse number 34 of chapter 18, it declares, and the battle increased that day. And the Lord says, you're experiencing the intensity of your battles because you're about to receive the manifestation of your victory. In the foregoing chapter, I don't want to hold you long. In the foregoing chapter, Jehoshaphat is at home in peace and in prosperity. But at the entrance of chapter 20, things begin to be chaotic. Hallelujah. He receives the news that a great multitude is coming against him. The Lord told me to tell somebody that this is a season of great attacks. This is a season of announced attacks. Let me explain. The reason why it hurt you like it hurt you, the reason why it did you like it did, the reason why it wounded you like it wounded you was because the attack was an announced. Hallelujah. But the Lord said, this is the season that you are to praise him for the announced attack. The reason why that it affected you like it did was because you didn't know it was coming from where it came from. You didn't know the attacks were coming from your family. You didn't know they were coming from your job. You didn't expect them to come from your church. You didn't expect them to come through your finances. But God is revealing your attacks, hallelujah, so that you can better prepare your line of defense. I want to call your attention to chapter number 20 of 2 Chronicles. The Bible said, and Jehoshaphat, in verse number 3, Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord. And he proclaimed a fast throughout all Judah. And Judah gathered themselves, according to verse 4, to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. That may be a season when leaders will become afraid while abiding in our assignments. Hallelujah. But it's during those times when we need those connected to us, not those attached, because those attached will eventually fall off. We need those who are connected to us, who will help us, lift us up in our assignment. The Bible says, as you begin to look at the historicity of the text, you find the Bible said that Jehoshaphat begins to plead his case with God. He says, are you not God in heaven? He says, and in thy hand is there not power and might, so that none is able to withstand thee. In verse 9 in the text, he says, if when evil cometh upon us, we stand before thy presence and cry unto thee in our affliction. He said, then thou will hear us. I'm telling somebody that God has not only heard you, but he's getting ready to help you. Hallelujah. The Bible says, because I don't want to hold you long. The Bible said in verse 10 that when they came against Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, they came against us, is what Jehoshaphat began to say. He said, now when they came against us, you wouldn't let us kill them. Hallelujah. He said, when we could have invaded them, you wouldn't let us kill us. But now the reason why they're coming against us, because they want to take what God has already given us. I don't know who I'm talking to tonight, but the enemy wants to destroy you from what God has already given you. But I came to prophetically declare that God's about to give you all your stuff back. Hallelujah. The Bible says, because I have to go, the Bible says that Jehoshaphat begins to talk to God. He says, look how they reward us. When we could have destroyed them, you wouldn't let us destroy them. But is for weakness. Somebody pray for me. The Bible says that he says when we could have killed them, that you wouldn't let us kill us. It's something how the ones that you covered, they no longer cover you. Hallelujah. The ones that you could have killed, but you protected, now they're trying to kill you. I'm telling somebody, God has you covered. Hallelujah. The Bible says that what happened now, he says, oh God, will you not judge them? Has anybody ever felt like God left you out there by yourself? He said, will you not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us. He says, neither know we what to do, but our eyes are unto thee. Hallelujah. David said in Psalms 121, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. Hallelujah. Psalms 25:15 declares that my eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. I wish I had a praiser here. The story gets interesting because the Bible says that here is a man by the name of Jehaziel, and the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehaziel. Jehaziel, in the Hebrew, it means to prophesy. Hallelujah. And so the spirit of prophecy comes upon Jehaziel, and Jehaziel began to say, hearken ye all Judah and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. I feel it. And thou King Jehoshaphat, watch now, he said, thus said the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed. Hallelujah. By reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Hallelujah. I wish you'd call somebody, tweet them, Facebook them, email them, text them, and tell them the Lord said the battle don't belong to you. It belongs to him. The Bible says, I begin to examine the word God's, and it is G-O-D, apostrophe S. The Bible says now, when I begin to study this word, the apostrophe means ownership. Hallelujah. It means possession. Hallelujah. It means that God is in possession of the battle. So I need to tell about 80 of y'all tonight that what's happening now, and I'm talking to the nation, and I'm telling you that God is getting ready to take ownership of your battle. And the thing about the battle is that he says, I own the battle, and I can give the victory to whoever I choose to give it to. Not only does he own the battle, but the word, the apostrophe also means omission. He says, not only am I going to give you the victory, but I'm going to leave you out of the battle and still give you the victory. I wish I had a praiser. He said, be not afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but the battle belongs to God. He says, tomorrow go ye down against them. Behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziz, and ye shall find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jaruth. I believe it was so prophetic as they began to open this show on tonight that they talked about there's no more time for the manna, but it is now time to walk in our place of fruitfulness. I don't know who I'm talking to, but the Lord says, tell you, he's about to give you instruction in the wilderness that's going to counterpole you to your next place of victory. I got to leave you. He says, ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them. I want to make something perfectly clear to you, that Jehoshaphat had just came out of a battle in chapter number 18. But although he was victorious, he had to be an active participant in this battle. And so by the time we get to chapter number 20, the Lord comes upon Jehaziel and tell Jehaziel to tell Jehoshaphat, you don't have to fight in this battle. Hallelujah. I know that you had to fight in the last battle. I know you have to fight all your life. Hallelujah. I know you've been having to fight on your job. You've been having to fight in your house. You've been having to fight in your church. I wish I had a praiser. But the Lord said that you don't have to fight in this battle. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I came to tell the ones that will open your spirits and hear this word on tonight that the Lord said the battle belongs to him. Hallelujah. He says the only thing I want you to do is position yourself because I'm about to give you a great victory. I gotta leave you now. The Bible says that he said the only thing I want you to do is set yourself, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. He says, fear not, nor be dismayed. I need to prophesy to the nation. I need to prophesy to the studio audience and tell you, the Lord said,